Hi, I'm Rachel from Doncaster on Late Lunch Tonight. Ali McCoist, Stephen Fry and Martine McCutcheon. Cue maestro, Eric.
With a boil the size of this. Together we are
Mel and Sue.
Welcome to this. This is Late Lunch on this Wednesday evening. With only 394 shopping days until next Christmas. Put in your diary.
Now then.
It's the 25th of December.
Now, who saw EastEnders last night?
Yeah?
Who saw EastEnders?
Well, lie if you have to, because Martine's coming on. We all saw EastEnders.
Is it just me, or does Beppe DiMarco look like a certain children's presenter?
Do it, Melly. Beppe DiMarco!
Isn't it?
And...
unbelievable.
Look at this. Rolf Harris. Dead ringer. Did you know, though, Mel, the cast of EastEnders have done a sort of job swap with Live and Kicking presenters?
No.
Beppe is now presenting Electric Circus. Hello and welcome to Electric Circus, didn't you know? And Frank Butcher is taking over from Zoe Ball.
Now, line one. Debbie from Wigan. What's your question for Boyzone, sweetheart?
Well...
that hurt my voice.
Good.
So just a mini laugh might be appreciated.
OK. EastEnders may have been last night, but tomorrow night it's Miss World, and frankly, I cannot wait.
But, Melly, you don't have... you don't have to wait for Miss World. Turn.
Turn.
We've got our very own... very own pageant of brains
Turn.
And beauty right here. Turn. the pageant of brains and beauty, not obviously here, but ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, it's late, Miss Late Lunch in 1998, the contenders. First up, Miss EastEnders, Martine McCutcheon. Martine is 22 years old. She is 5'6" and has spent most of her life behind bars. Her favourite expression is... She's disqualified as a masseuse, but is she any good, or is she just shiatsu? Ladies and gentlemen, Martine McCutcheon.
Our next contestant, Miss North End, is Ali McCoist. Ali is 36 and quite tall. He's the reigning Miss Kilmarnock and enjoys tossing the caber. There was a disagreement about whether he'd appear in swimwear, but eventually we told him he couldn't. Ladies and gentlemen, Ali McCoist.
And finally, contestant number three. He took 4 hours to get into his sash. It's Mr. West End, Stephen Fry. If there was one thing in the world he'd change, it'd be his pants. Ladies and gentlemen, sex god, Stephen Fry.
Yeah!
Oh! What a lineup!
So tonight we literally celebrate our celebrity lineup. As we say, I'll have two Big Macs and a large fry.
Now, please. We'd like to make our guests available to you at home. So if you'd like to ask Stephen, Ali or Martine if they'd like to travel the world and work with children, hey, then call us on 09904LUNCH. If you have an alphabetical phone, if you don't, it's 09904045.
I was on Pet Rescue last week.
That's the official voice of a cat there. Mel has patented that voice, so if you wish to do another cat voice sounding like it, you'll have to ask for permission. 86.
I was on animal... I was on animal hospital last week.
24.
Sorry.
Sorry.
I was on Ready Steady Cook last week. Good for you.
Or you can fax us if you want while we're cluttering around with lots of masks on 0990 to lunch. And that is
0990 25.
People laugh at me because of my jokes.
86.
People laugh at me because of my impressions.
24.
I don't know. I just don't know why people laugh at me. But please stop. It's a sort of pathetic moment like you get at the end of Pet Rescue.
Hello there. Hello.
Right, let's spend more time with that. But let's not. Today's band plays homage to the funniest and cleverest Stephen in the world. Bad luck, Stephen McCoist. It's not you. In comparison, all others are small fry, so please go Oscar Wilde for Steve, Matt, Dylan and Denial. It's Jamira Fry!
Cheers, band. Today's chief, or chef, or even chef, is one of Scotland's most capped footballers. After his debut against Holland in 1986, he promised his wife a holiday every time they beat England. She's never left Scotland. Luckily, he has. It's the wonderful Ali McCoist!
Nice to see you.
You stand right there. Ali McCoist has very, very good sort of sachet on the catwalk style.
You think so?
Very, very good.
Well, I don't think the competition was that fierce, actually. I'm only joking. I'm only joking.
Now, right. What are you cooking for us today?
Steak balmoral, actually.
Steak balmoral?
I've never cooked it before in my entire puff.
Right.
I have eaten it a few times. And I'm looking forward to the occasion tonight, so it should be good fun,
okay.
Good fun. Do you have paramedics and fire engine things like standing by?
That's all lined up, mate, just in case.
That's good, that's
anyway,
all right.
Just about to do a gag, so here we go. Today we're going to have steak balmoral with boulanger potatoes. Make mine a large scotch.
I didn't write that. Okay. I had nothing to do with it.
All right, darling. Now, what's first up on the old cookery?
Right. First of all, what we've got, we're putting the mushrooms, right?
Yeah.
With me so far?
I'm with you, doll.
And onions.
Right.
Into the frying pan. So we'll move this over here.
Okay.
And I was told that was quite hot. So what we'll do this time, we'll use these.
All right, darling. Do you want the other one? Are you okay?
No, we're okay. We're fine.
But you're not just a footballer now, Ali. You're a TV presenter as well.
No. Don't start that.
It's the truth. It's the truth, though. Okay. You don't want to talk about it?
Yeah, if you want.
Who's here?
I thought you'd never ask.
Lovely eyes. Cornflower blue eyes.
Do you think so?
Yeah, lovely. Who's your mentor, then, in the sort of TV presenting?
Dez. It's got to be Dez, hasn't
King,
it?
Yeah, King Desmondo,
Dez
always.
He's the best ever, isn't he? He's fantastic.
Did he give you tips?
No, but you watch him, actually. He's a legend. And, just what you see is what you get with Desi. Have you ever seen him so cool in front of a camera in your entire life? He's brilliant, isn't he?
He's beautiful.
He's never said a Mr. Word or Mr. Q. He's great. He's different class. So we're trying to rustle these up, right? This is the initial start of the whole fire brigade scene. In about 15 minutes, we'll dial 999, right?
Hope not.
No, we won't. Don't worry, we won't.
I must ask you know the World Cup?
Yes.
You were the pundit, I have to say. For my money, the pundit, The hair.
The hair.
The blonde, the blonde dyed hair. Why did you do that? Do you like it?
I was pissed. What happened was...
Ali was hoovered.
Are you allowed to say that? We went to Canada. Once I found out I wasn't in the squad, I've never done that before.
That's good. That's sort of leaning.
That's
very good.
45 degree angle steak by moral.
Excellent.
What happened was I never got in the squad, right? And... we're pretty disappointed and dejected, the whole thing.
Yeah.
But myself and Stuart McCall decided, hey, we're not in the squad. Let's go and enjoy ourselves.
Yeah, good call.
So we went to Toronto with seven or eight of the lads. And Ended up making a shambles.
Had a few drinks.
Making a shambles in my head after a few Molson Canadians.
Ah, okay. Like the Romanian team.
Ah, we did it before. We did it first.
Ah, you see.
So basically, we were pushed before them.
Okay.
No.
Okay. Now, Dol, what's going on? Are we going to stack anything with those potatoes?
Yes.
Anything going to happen over there? Do you want me to
stir these? Could you just keep a hold of that? What we're going to do is, the potatoes.
Right.
Now, I have washed my hands because children, you always wash your hands. The children
are
that.
Of course, Dolly. Now, you've got a bit of a reputation because all the football...
It's not washing my hands?
No. Oh, no, they're clean. I saw you do it. They're clean. Oh, I didn't see... Well, I said anyway.
We had some time.
The all the football managers that you've worked with have actually hit you, haven't they?
Yeah.
Why?
Oh, they've hated me.
Every single one you've ever worked with?
Well, they've taken an instant dislike to me.
Why? You're so nice.
Because it saves time.
Really?
Boom! Right, what am I doing here now? Yes, we're adding all sorts
of... We're stacking the potatoes with some... What's those herbs?
Thyme.
Thyme. Thyme.
You've got to do. You always add thyme. A little bit, some more mushrooms on here.
Okay, groovy. Lovely. Now, Sue...
And the stock.
All right, Dol. Are you okay there?
Yeah, I just like talking to myself.
That's
carry
fine.
On.
You carry on.
I always talk to myself.
You mumble on to yourself there. That's fine. Now, Sue, there's a guy in a kilt next to you. Can you ask him if you can have a look underneath it, maybe?
I will do. Yeah, Pete, sorry. Do you mind?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to do it nonetheless. Good Lord. Well, proof indeed that Pete goes like a train. That's what I call a flying Scotsman. Thanks very much. It was delightful to lay my hands on your regional skirt. Thank you. Right, I'm going to move on down, because as Martine McCutcheon is going to be joining us very shortly, we thought we'd have our own EastEnders trivia quiz. So let's play Celebrity Albert Squares. Was that the theme music to Pet Rescue? Okay, we've got two teams here. You are now going to be holding the green baton, so you'll be the green team. But we have all ladies here on the red team. Now, what's your names?
Sarah. Fiona.
Steph.
Sarah, Fiona and Steph. Excellent. And in the green team, you talk us through your teammates?
Ray.
Ollie.
Paul.
Tip Van Top. Now, we've got three questions coming up about Albert Square, OK? Now, instead of buzzers, the girls, you have to shout out, Ricky! All right, so can we check your buzzer sound, please? One, two, three.
Ricky!
Lovely buzzer. Use that to buzz in if you have the answer. Team B, the boys' team, please, will you buzz in with Pets? Beautiful darts, lads. OK, voice boxes at the ready as here we go. Question number one. Whose hands are these?
Pat.
They are indeed Pat. That was very good. That was an excellent twist of fate. OK, question two. This is working very well. So the second answer is Ricky. Whose does this belong to? This is a vanity case. Who might this belong to?
Ricky!
No, it's not Ricky's. it could be, I don't know. Perhaps I shouldn't be so hasty. Let's have a look inside. Who do you think it belongs to? Can't open it, of course. It's just all for sham. Peggy. You can't buzz in and not know.
Peggy
do you
Mitchell.
Never watch the quiz show?
Peggy
Tiffany. Mitchell. It is Tiffany's. After three attempts, I will give it to you. So we're one all. We're neck and neck in this rather slow derby. Right, OK. Number three, it's a singing round, because I do like to humiliate you as much as I'm humiliating myself currently. OK, now the final question decided. You both have to hum the theme tune of EastEnders. So, Team A, I'll ask you to go first. Hum the theme tune. Lovely. That was beautiful. Team B. They're going to the barbershop, I see. That's lovely. That's they're auditioning. They've used this show as a vehicle for their barbershop trio, I have to say. I'm torn. Stevie, what do you reckon? Who's going to win out in those?
The barbershop, the green team.
The green team won, the lads. The lads have won. OK, you get, unfortunately, not the vanity case.
Oh.
I'm afraid that's not in my gift at all. That's in Martine's gift. So I'm going to present you with... Let's see, with this suit. No, it's not you, that one. let's have a look at this one. That's a red.
Better.
Yes, I think that's yours. Round of applause for two teams! Applause. because it wasn't that good. Now, back, yo people, to the food thing, because I'm down with the kids and hip with the youth, whatever on earth that means. Melly G is here, featuring MC Coist. What's cooking, people?
I'm getting down in the kitchen with Ali McC. You, Ali. You.
I'm a hip, I'm a hep, and I'm a making the tea.
He's tall and he's Scottish and he's very good looking, so turn up the heat and let's get cooking, yo. Yo, Ali. Yeah, man. Go, let me just put your sash, put your little sash up there.
Us Glasgow rappers always have another beat before we...
Al, how's it going, mate?
It's going okay, we're surviving.
These are sort of sweated down, they're looking good.
Yeah. Now, what we do is, the big secret now is, make a bit of space, right?
Right.
And we add Stephen or Martine's fillet steak.
Very good. I remember seeing you on TV once, Ali.
Yeah?
On the Big Breakfast, when Keith Chegwin pitched up at your house, basically woke you up.
Yeah.
And then something disastrous.
Wrecked my kitchen.
He sat on.
He did.
He sat on.
Never mind laughing about it. He wrecked my kitchen.
What did he do?
He jumped up dead cool on my kitchen bench, yeah. And the whole thing collapsed. But you've got to love him. He's a nice guy. He's a nice guy, and he paid the bill immediately, almost immediately. Aww. So, nah, he's a nice guy. But he wrecked the kitchen.
Is Gazza a bit like that? Is he a bit of a sort of?
Oh, you'd love Gazza.
Oh, we've never met him. Never met him.
Well,
is he a good man?
I'll tell you a story. I was lying in bed with my good lady, right? 5:30 one morning. Are you going to stir that while I'm talking?
Yeah.
And what happened? Alison said to me. She turned and said to me. She said, "There's somebody downstairs." I woke up five. I said, "What, you're choking?" I went. Sure enough, I heard somebody downstairs. Right, 5:30 in the morning. So I jumped out of my bed and I went hearing downstairs as you do, panicking. I don't know what to expect, you know. And I opened up the kitchen. You carry on, you do stuff there.
Yep.
Carried on. Opened the kitchen door up, and there, to my amazement, was Gascoigne. I know.
Sorry.
We're adding a whiskey. Okay. Was Gascoigne in my fridge? He was in my fridge.
Like Cato,
just
actually
in my fridge.
In it, or
not completely, and it's sort of half outside. I said, Gaz, I said, "What are you doing?" And he looked at me as if I was the daft one and said, "I'm making a sani." I said, "But it's 5:30 in the morning." I said, "How did you get in?" He said, "Well, remember that time I dropped you off and you were on the phone to Alison?"
Yes.
"And you'd let slip where you keep the spare set of keys?"
Yeah.
I said, "Yeah." He said, "Well, I just came in and used them."
Lovely.
5:30 in the morning.
Very good. What was in the sarnie? Can you remember? What did he put in?
There's a joke there somewhere, but I'll go right over the top and say ham, which isn't funny, but I think it's safer.
Anyway, you know, as you do.
Can I add the most important ingredient?
Right, get it in.
For steak, but this is whiskey.
Hey.
Right.
Ooh.
And now, do you know what we do now?
That's we'll
light
a good
it.
Around.
We'll light it.
Easy, McCoist. Easy there.
Right,
easy,
here we
my
go.
Lamb.
Here we go. Now, careful.
Right,
careful now.
It's gone out.
Careful now.
All the best. Put some cream in there, maybe?
Yeah. That's maybe.
Just
here we are, we're in. We're in this.
Should I put this in over?
No.
Nope.
Maybe not. What will we try again is?
Might put some cream in, mate. I think we're slightly panning
you
on the
think
old
so?
Wicker.
I would add some cream, I don't know about you.
Okay, should I put some cream in?
Yeah, I'd
there
go
we
it.
Go. Didn't work with the old flambé, but I think we've just saved the day there, hopefully.
Actually, the four times I've had it.
You've never cooked it before!
I know. But the four times I've had it, once was with flambé, didn't enjoy it at all.
Which is a
real bonus, because we've not got the flambé this evening.
OK.
So how's it looking?
It's looking pretty disgusting, actually, but... no, it's fine. The beans are there. The beans are simmering away.
That's OK. That's not too bad, then.
Now, Ali, I understand on the sort of football/TV presenters grapevine that you're one of the few Scotsmen brave enough to do a Sean Connery impression. Would you please trail us into the break, maybe, as the definitive Bond on this...
Yeah, I mean, that's a challenge.
This camera here, maybe?
Which camera?
This one there, just there.
Will I have to make it up? Or will I just read the autocue?
Just read what's on there. I'll be your pussy galore.
Thanks very much. Pushy, let's get together. If you could join us after a break for tonight's other special guest, Fry. That's Stephen Fry. An EastEnders star. McCutcheon. That's Martine McCutcheon. Stay tuned. We'll see you in 003. Thank you.
Brock is dead. They should know they put the final nail in his coffin. Welcome back to Late Lunch, where very shortly we'll be dining with the brilliant Stephen Fry and the marvellous Martine McCutcheon.
Before I go back to the kitchen to finish off cooking with Annie McCoist, it's time to rip open the packet that is the news and pull out a topical crisp.
Crunch.
There could soon be a cure for baldness after scientists found a way of breeding very hairy mice. The treatment is a long way from being perfected, but when it is, it won't be free. You'll have to pay.
Hey, you're very much done. Dylan will be getting repetitive strain injury in the next 1 minute. Gary Lineker has revealed that he deliberately avoided heading the ball because he thought it would damage his IQ. Gazza, on the other hand, said, I cannot be worried about IQ. I go shopping there most weekends. Like.
David Beckham is growing a beard. Mm. He said he's doing it because at some stage in their careers, all his sporting heroes did the same. Mm. George Best, Diego Maradona and Fatima Whitbread.
Mm. What a walrus that is.
Look at the little
marmot. Don't detract from you being horrible about Fatima Whitbread.
The little
marmot. She's a sucker for a cavey.
That'll get the website buzzing. Now, I'm off to the kitchen for a quick Highland fling with a lie. A lie. Doll, the hat's come off.
The hat's off.
Little bit of bedhead. Let me just do some...
Be fine?
Yeah, you're all right, mate.
What do you think?
Beautiful.
Okay.
Superb. How's the old
Balmoral? I'll tell you what, honest to God, it's looking fantastic. It really is. Stephen and Martine just...
They're going to like it.
Oh, I would have thought so.
Are you a big EastEnders fan?
Yeah.
EastEnders?
I must admit, I've got, I can't lie.
Is it another story, Ellie?
No, I enjoy it, but I'm more of a Corrie man, which...
Don't say that to David.
I'm more of a EastEnders fan than a Corrie man, that's what I meant.
Do you watch Take the High Road? Oh,
yes.
It's called High Road.
Of course you do, it's called High Road. Change his name, yeah. Yeah.
Mrs. Mack.
What do you think?
Yeah. I've never seen it. Anyway. Now, Ellie, mate.
It's called you.
You're on the question of sports.
Yep.
I have to say, really like you on that, because everyone else is a bit sort of... Pringly, do you know what I mean? Bit sort of beigey pringly, but you are the cornflower blue-eyed god.
You think so?
On that, yeah.
You think so?
Yes, you are.
Okay.
So, in honour of question of sports style, Ali, would you like home or away? Choose home or away. Home or away.
We'll go danger. We'll go away.
Go away. Yeah. Right, away. Ali McCoist, where was your last holiday?
She just keeps laughing at everything. Spain. 1997.
Good. Factual answer there.
Marbella. If you push me, I'll tell you Marbella.
Let's go for the home one now.
Okay.
Home, Ali McCoist.
Yeah.
How many rooms are there in your home?
Oh. Slept in most of them. 1, 2, 3.
Bedroom. Kitchen.
I'll take another away.
That's what I haven't got any more,
Dom. Okay, 10.
10. 10 rooms in your home.
10.
Good, that went well. Now, Ali, do you want to sort of dish that up now, mate?
Of course.
That looks very,
what do you think?
Very good.
Seriously?
It looks excellent, actually.
Right. I think we'll use this other wee fella here.
Now, Ali, do you want some help?
Yeah, that'd be great, thanks. This wee guy.
Do you scoop that out? Yeah.
That's
you
the
know
one.
That you came on with a sash at the beginning? You're a contender for the Miss Late Lunch 1998.
I don't really contain myself here.
Ali, if you win tonight, what will you do with your year?
Spend the entire year laughing at Martine and Stephen, probably.
Oh.
What do you think?
Very good. Good response. Ali, that looks...
I don't think it was. I think I mean...
That looks groovy, Ali. Cheers for that. Now,
it's
Ali, you're going to be joining us later to play this week's sporting innovation, which is salad football. But until then, you're very welcome to sit with the audience and canvas voters to win you that prestigious title
of Michelle.
Miss Late Lunch 1998.
There we are.
Cool. Band, are you hungry?
Yes!
Not you, that was the band.
I'm always hungry.
Audience, are you hungry?
Yes!
Ali, are you hungry?
Nah, I couldn't eat a thing, mate. Then
let's eat a late lunch!
Us again. Today's first guest is the Princess of the Queen Vic, and she is certainly Grant maintained. Please welcome the one and only Martine McCutcheon!
Oh,
is a man with a huge IQ. He puts the fry into frighteningly talented, the one and only Stephen Fry!
It's good.
Now that the noise is over, welcome. And have you two met before?
We haven't, no. It's our first time. It's very exciting for
me. Ignored me in the makeup room.
No, he didn't.
No, I didn't. No. I saw her reflection, you see, and I didn't recognise her.
No,
don't.
Oh, my God, Stephen. And I went, hello.
I think we should hear Stephen's side.
I thought it was the makeup artist saying hello, so I said hello to the makeup artist, and then I noticed you in your reflection.
They do it with mirrors, you see.
She looks
different.
It's because
I was being spoiled.
That's why you couldn't really see me, could you?
I couldn't.
Now, do you tuck in, by the way? Stop. We've got to do this thing with a napkin, otherwise 4,000 people
write in. I don't know if I want to eat this now that he's more of a Corey fan rather than an EastEnders fan.
He was a silly ghost, to say it. He was a capricious ghost.
He's put me off.
It's tasty.
Can't handle it!
There's a very good phrase that Mike Reed had in one episode of your television programme.
Only one?
Yeah, no, well, he has lots of... But I use it a lot. He said, he turned to Pat. He said, oi, Pat, have a word with yourself. Good, isn't it?
Have a word with yourself.
Have a word with yourself.
Did he say donut at the end of it? Because he says that quite a lot. Sweetheart, donut.
He's actually becoming completely incomprehensible.
With me, he is, because my impression is... Stephen, I want to talk first about a very important thing, and that is what we're doing on Saturday night. It's World AIDS Night on Channel 4. And you are the head honcho of the evening. You're culling together some comedians, some celebrities, and us. And I just wanted to know what exactly we're doing.
What are we doing? Do you know?
We don't know. Is that your mobile going on?
No, it's my
pager. Who is it? Who is it?
Get someone's agent. Get off now.
While we're going saying, I bet you've left your pager on.
It's my send, I love you.
Yes, I'm sorry about that.
Do you want to answer back? You can wait for the break.
It's fine.
That's cool.
It's
we'll get you a phone.
Yes, Saturday night. We too. Sadly, Martine can't make it. That's a shame. But it is World AIDS Day, the 1st of December, as you probably know.
Yes.
We're hosting a programme, aren't we? Live from the lighthouse.
Yeah. I think our job is to set up the phones or something.
I think we're just actually installing the phones.
You've been manning the phones. Staffing the phones.
We're staffing the phones.
Ladying the phones.
Womaning the phones.
Womaning the phones. Yes, it should be fun. We've got a lot of people. It's Steve Coogan we've got Elton John's just doing something
top
a couple
dart.
Of days' time.
Brilliant.
That's fine. Harry Enfield.
Brilliant. So basically, people better watch it.
Well, I hope so. You see, part of the problem is people think it's gone away.
No,
and
exactly.
It hasn't. It's rather like a mushroom, of which there are some delicious ones here. No, Martine, be fair. Mushrooms flourish in the dark, you see, and AIDS is rather the same. The more you keep it in the dark, the more it flourishes. The more light you shine upon it, the more it shrinks away.
Oh, that's really well put.
Thank you.
He is the master of the well put.
So
basically, it's to sort of raise awareness and say that this just wasn't a fashionable thing that happened in the 80s and has gone away.
That's right. In fact, because rates of infection amongst women are actually increasing, rather, unfortunately. Of course, there are drugs that are helping a great deal. But they're not everything. Stop it, in the audience. That's not what I meant at all. They're all eating busily, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. Frantically eating.
Little pots.
Well, I hope I'm really sincerely hope a lot of people watch it. Mm. And watch us playing around. I think it'll be top. I want to ask if you've ever seen Martine on the telly. Mm. Have you ever watched EastEnders?
Well, I have to be honest and say, I'm not a regular watcher. But I do obviously pop in from time to time.
You visit occasionally the square.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm going to do, Stephen,
Sunday. Oh God, no!
I am going to It's not nudity now. Good. I'm not going to show a still of you from late 70s. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a bit of background on Martine's alter ego, Tiffany.
Oh.
Well, Stephen, Tiffany arrived in Albert Square in 1995. She started going out with Tony Hills until he started going out with her brother Simon. Whilst going out with Tony, she got pregnant. Tony thought it was his, but Tiffany wasn't too sure. The baby was born. It was Courtney. Grant turned out to be the father. Tiff married Grant. They split up. They got back together. Grant had an affair with Tiff's mother. Tiff learned to be a masseuse. They got back together again. Grant gave her pants for their anniversary. Tiff snogged Beppe. Tiff and Grant had nookie, and last night they spent a lovely-dovely evening in with some water candles. And that is pretty good synopsis, isn't it?
That is wonderful.
That's what's happened to you. That's a pretty much a roller coaster ride.
Can you sue if somebody actually takes your life and puts it on screen? You can sue, can't you?
I'm upset that you...
That was actually directly taken from my life, except for the water candles. They weren't water candles.
What did you use instead?
Those little nightlight, you know, sentinel ones.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah. But otherwise, it's identical to my life.
Good luck. I don't know how on earth you've managed to keep up with that pace when you were playing Tiffany. I mean, that is one hell of a plot, isn't it?
Certainly is.
Those knickers.
Yeah.
Those knickers
are
cold.
Those knickers.
Those knickers are yours.
Melanie, you've got some detritus on your upper lip there.
Sorry, that's
I've initially put.
But those knickers that Grant gave you.
Yeah.
Didn't like those.
They were on the foam side of decency.
I didn't either. I didn't think they were all there.
They weren't that Tiffany, were they, those knickers? But it doesn't matter, you know, whatever.
No, I thought she'd have something really, really saucy. Really saucy.
It was basically an upmarket thong, wasn't it?
I don't know what it was.
it wasn't good, is what we're saying. We're saying the pants, Grant,
given that your character was named after a jewellery shop, it's just as well they weren't called Ratner, isn't it?
Yes.
You'd have left an awful lot sooner, that's for sure. You were there for a long time, 3 years pretty much, wasn't it?
4 years.
4 years.
4 years.
4 years.
Yeah.
And you
four of your Earth years.
Yes. Yes. The time units they call years.
Your puny years.
What are these years of which you speak? But you know, you've left now. You filmed the last episode.
Yeah.
So what's coming up next for you now? Now you've said goodbye to the square.
Okay. Well, I'm definitely going to carry on acting. That's something I definitely want to do. Yeah, I don't
absolutely.
Sort of say
bye-bye.
Good call.
And he has become Frank Butcher. never thought it would happen. And I'm also now signed to Virgin. Virgin record label, got a 5-album deal. Signed a wonderful deal.
Brilliant.
I'm really excited.
So you've learned where the exit doors are and everything.
Dylan's on the ball then. No. But what would you miss about the square most? I mean, you, as you say, there for 4 years. I mean, you've got to have made some good friends there. And
yes, the people. Enough. Definitely the people.
Who will you
especially
miss most?
Patsy.
Oh, so you won't miss Rolo or any of the dogs or anything? You won't miss...
Rolo was... I think he was dead when I arrived.
Well, he never died for me.
Rolo.
I called him Rolo. Rolo. It was a pet name. It was an affectionate term I used to describe a dog that was cruelly ripped from
the
television.
That was really good.
Never give anyone your last dog.
No, exactly. We like to bring the tone of the conversation down to snogging always, Martine, and you have snogged lots of people on the television, Grant and Tony, and you've snogged Beppe.
Quite jealous of that. Quite jealous.
Beppe's have you seen Beppe?
Like Beppe.
He literally is the Italian stallion. The accent is dodgy, but the face is nice.
The facial hair there is not good. It's not good.
You don't like it?
Miss Erotica.
Wasn't there
you weren't watching that. You were watching UK Pewter. You weren't watching.
No, I was reading news on my computer, and it said something
about over here now.
Somebody.
What's going on?
One of your confrères or consoeurs, wasn't allowed to judge a beauty or erotic prize.
Oh really?
Yeah. What's in the paper? Did somebody? I'm not the only one who's heard this story, am I? Oh God, I am.
Don't we've all been? I don't think we've been to the same websites as you
oh,
have.
Oh dear, oh dear. That's what I read.
Back to snogging.
Yeah. Yes. Sorry.
Who was the best of the three at snogging?
Oh, Beppe, gotta be. Yeah.
But you only had a little one of these jobs with Beppe. Like that.
You know what? They're all quite talented in their own way. They're all sort of like, you know, they're all quite. You know, their own little.
Beppe wants to continue because you got out of the car and he was literally just, you know, just getting into it. And he left.
It's like the strongest horse, isn't it? When someone moves away.
Crossbreed or Labrador?
I think he's a crossbreed. I'm not sure. I haven't really checked into his family origins. But Tony Hills, Mark Homer came on and said you were the best snogger out of everyone he snogged.
Yeah, he did.
It's official.
Yeah, he did.
I didn't act surprised, but I actually heard about that and I was really pleased.
That's very good. Now, I want to talk about lying very briefly. Your book, obviously, The Liar, which is very successful. Would you say...
Have you written a book on The Liar as well?
one can paint the idea of lying.
Thank you.
But are you a good liar in real life, Stephen? Can you con a conner?
No, I can't. It's that famous line, as you say, which you almost quoted of Bert Lancaster. Forgive me for speaking my mouthful. You know, never kid a kidder, isn't it? Sweet smell of success or something like that. And I can't. I'm a hopeless liar. I mean... I think that my nightmare is being in some court case and a barrister saying, well, of course you'd say you're an actor, naturally you will persuade a jury. Because I know that I would just go all pink and flustered and hopeless.
And you'd look down.
Yeah.
Well, if we asked you now to tell us three things about yourself, one of them will be a lie, and Martine has to guess which one you think is a lie.
Okay. Three things. I love indoor bowls.
Okay.
That's one. I'm Jewish, that's two. I speak almost fluent Spanish, that's three. One of those is a lie.
Am I allowed to do this as well?
After Monty?
Okay.
Wait your turn. You're not the guest on the show.
I think you're Jewish.
You think that's a lie?
No.
No, you don't agree.
No, indoor bowls.
You're both wrong.
I think it's Spanish.
You're right.
That's why I waited till third to answer.
I speak barely a word of Spanish, but I do love indoor bowls.
Oh, okay.
I am Jewish, yeah. And I can barely speak Spanish.
Okay,
you were a very convincing one.
Thank you very much.
Right.
Well, thank you, darling.
Fellow eaters, now it's time to discard the puny Lilo of small talk, grasp hold of the sturdy surfboard of honesty, and ride the wave of truth. It's the late lunch big three.
Flatulent Dan.
Steve, I'm going to ask you both these questions. OK, Stephen, who would you be starstruck by if you met them?
Clint.
Eastwood or...?
In Eastwood. Is there another?
I thought it was, you were going to say Bill Clinton.
No.
That's fine. OK. Martine, who would you be...
Man,
did you say
Clint? I don't know,
doll.
It was just my own little thing there.
Marcus Baines.
Sorry, doll. Martine, who would you be starstruck by if you met them?
Barbara Streisand.
Ah, good response.
Yeah, definitely.
I would agree with that. I'd also be
Stephen, what's by your bed?
I'm sorry?
What's part of the big three?
What's by my bed?
What's by your bed?
It's a very unusual collection of things. A bedside lamp.
I bet you've got slippers.
I don't have
slippers. No, I see tartan slippers with fleece inside.
It's your own sad world. I'm afraid I don't have it. my feet sleep nude.
Right.
An alarm clock.
Right.
Again, bizarre thing to have by the bed. A book. Or usually two books.
One of your own?
No. I mustn't get excited when I sleep.
Okay. That's a big enough answer.
Yeah.
That's a big enough answer. And a telephone. Yeah. Okay, lovely. Martin, what's by your bed?
Big bottle of water.
Right.
Which was a bottle of water.
Yep.
By your bed.
Yep, that's true.
You should.
And it's a big bottle of something else in the morning, presumably. Saves you a journey to the lavatory every
day. Yeah, definitely. And thanks for that.
Sorry.
I've got a horrible image in my mind now.
My brother does that.
I'm not going to have that bottle by my bed anymore.
Let's crash on with number three. Stephen, if you were chosen, let's say if you were chosen as...
Nothing else by my bed, then.
Bottle of water.
Big bottle of water.
In the day.
And a hovering illusion of urine. We won't deal with again.
If you were chosen, Stephen, as Miss Late Lunch 98, how would you spend your year?
I suppose the usual answer, the answer they all give, isn't it? Helping starvation and wiping out children.
Martine, how would you spend... I'm turning to Stuart Hall. What's going on?
Martine, the Belgians.
Martine.
She's gone. She's completely gone.
Martine, if you were chosen as Miss Late Lunch 98, how would you spend your year?
Probably in loads and loads of chocolate, getting really spotty and really fat, and I can do a before and after.
You're a darn good egg. Yeah. I like that.
Definitely.
Excellent.
And I still won't be this world at the end of it.
Exactly.
That'd be brilliant.
OK, well, you've given your answers, and the judges now, that's that ramshackle lot over there. taking your answers and taking all those things into consideration. Now join us after the break, when we'll be announcing the winner of Miss Late Lunch 1998. And who was that? Earthly flatulent Daniel. I told you, don't eat dates before the show. Martine and Stephen will be put on the spot against Annie McCoist in our latest gastronomic sporting spectacle. It's salad, football. See you in celery.
He's got cornflower blue eyes, though. And
with me. And very tight trousers. Welcome back to Late Lunch. In a moment, Martine McCutcheon, Stephen Fry, and Annie McCoist will be kicking off our new spotting sensation, salad football. Is it salad?
Spell it. Salad football.
Well, it might be spallard. It might be spallard football. Why are we doing it? Because we can. First, that noise earlier that you sound, that sort of banging, thrashing, crashing, strumming, was the band's tribute to you, Martine. Can you tell me what song you think it was they were attempting to play?
It was definitely first song ever bought. Oh, Mickey by Tony Basil.
Well, it's bad you succeeded that she recognised it.
I remember that. Thank you.
I think
they are. They're all
wonderful band.
We love them.
I laugh at them, but frankly, I do think they're all hot rocks.
They are. They are groovy.
Steve, what was your first single that you bought?
Perhaps I could play that. Yes, it was The Ride of the Valkyries by Richard Wagner.
No.
I didn't think you could get that in a single.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, it wasn't.
Just being an old
Did you go for the 12-inch dance remix version?
I might have been Seasons in the Sun, I'm embarrassed to say, by Terry Jacks. You remember that?
I don't remember that one.
We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun.
And we've just now paid about £100 for singing it.
Good.
Scraped our hearts and scraped our knees.
What was your first single, Ali?
Steve Harley and Cockney Rebel.
Very cool, very
Come
good.
Come up and see me and make me smile.
Wow. I will do, that's a great offer. Oh, that was a song.
The
song was called Mr. Stoff. Soft?
Mr. Soft.
Stoff?
Mr. Soft.
But Soft. Come up and see me and make me smile anyway.
And it had that pause in the middle of it. It suddenly stopped. And in the disco, right. Everybody who was cool used to pretend they could. No, when it came back
My first
that
single
was the only bit I was in.
Right. You were raving away in that bit.
My first single was Chicory Tip, Son of My Father.
Oh. Ah. Mine was something fairly lame and nondescript, like Bucks Fizz. Can't even remember the name of it, but they, you know, they sort
for
of...
For making you mind up, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, it's quite a pop star.
Martine, you are, let's ruddy face it, you're going to be very, very big on the old female vocals front. You're
going to
be.
Wonderful for you to say.
No, you singing? Are. What, mate?
Do you mean singing?
Yes, I'm vocal singing.
Front.
Yes.
On that ruddy front.
On that ruddy front. But let's just cut back a little bit in time. Let's rewind life a little bit.
Embarrassing.
I would like to talk to you about Milan. Your band, Milan. Shall we have? Is it too? Is it too painful?
Don't run away from Milan.
Embrace Milan.
I'm going.
Embrace Milan.
Hold it.
Let's
embrace it. Feel the pain.
Let's feel the pain and embrace Milan in action.
Yeah. Do you know when they can just put whatever background you want? You know, you can either be on the embankment floating along the sea.
I love that.
That's what it looks like.
Brilliant. Yeah. I think it's very top darts.
Yeah, no, but it costs more than £20 to do.
Yeah, but you get to watch yourself
in the loop.
Back
all that money from, you know, it's all recoupable. Sort of something like
£35,000. Isn't it? That's what they do without you knowing, isn't it? When you start out. You know, you think you've got a brilliant contract, then you discover you have to pay for your own adverts.
Yeah, we've got all this money. This is fantastic.
They prey on you.
I want to spearhead a campaign to get Milan back in the charts.
Milan.
Ladies and gentlemen, as contestants for Miss Late Lunch, we've now found out a little bit of... have we got results of that coming in? I think we're going to keep that, actually. Why don't I keep the results? Because I know. OK. Now it's time, I think, for the one and only, the game you've all been looking forward to. It's salad football.
Very good.
Do it, Matt.
For you, Ali. I'll give you a hand with those, darling. Come here, my lovelies. Come here, Stephen and Martine.
Do this.
Doll, it's going to be
I'm
an absolute
wearing
treat.
Flat shoes
You've
for
got
you.
The trousers on, you're all set. The rules are very simple. So to keep it fair, Ali, my love, you are in goal. I will give you a hand here.
Thank you.
We're just putting on some special glove protection for Ali McCoist. Just in case, you know, they boot it really
That's
hard.
That's a bit of luck, me having small hands, isn't it?
Are you all right there, mate?
Yeah,
that's
it.
Okay. Right, you go between the sticks, whatever. Martine and Stephen, you have three. Three lettuce penalties
Is
each.
Is it the lettuce that you thought it was going to be?
It's an iceberg, I think, isn't
it's
it?
It's a bit of an iceberg here.
I was hoping for a little gem.
Oh, mate, you'll take alternate shots.
Right.
Alternate shots. The one who gets the most shot actually wins the game. Martine, you... Actually, no. It's traditional in this game to see who's got the longest fingernails to determine who goes first.
I think you have. Stephen has.
Stephen's got the longest one. Stephen. Stephen. Ali, get in the goal.
Oh. Okay.
Right, Stephen.
He's not allowed to move, is he?
You can move, but he can't.
Right. Eventually.
Okay, yeah. Right. Yeah. Lads.
I'm allowed to move eventually.
Lad in the band, if you please. Go, all Stephen. Right. Play the football. Who won that?
It was a draw.
It was a draw, wasn't it? It was two all. So I don't quite know what we do about that, but we'll sort out prizes for the two of you. Ali, how do you feel in your salad?
Well, I'll tell you something, the word expert springs to mind, those penalty kicks, I'll tell you.
Right, lads, can we have a quick look at the action replay, maybe, on
no.
that?
No.
I was more worried about me.
Do you want to go back over there? There you go.
There we go. Oh. Sit yourself down, then. Excellent. I'm sorry, there's a woman talking in my ear. And I became so entranced by her. She has this, I can't tell you, she's got a lyrical swing to her voice.
Oh, you're right.
She's saying, you big silly. We haven't done that very
according
well.
According to Accurist.
The time will be. OK, now we're going to go to the phone line. Sorry about that. They've been going crazy in a hereditary peer at the House of Lords. Hello. Who are you and have you come to save me from my own inadequacies? It's line one, it's Amber. Hi there, Amber.
Hello.
Is it Amber or is it Alison?
No, it's Amber.
Amber, hi there, mate. How are you doing?
I'm fine, I'm good, yeah.
Top darts. Who's your question for?
It's for everyone. What was on the last set of photographs that you developed?
What was on the last set of photographs? That's a very good question.
Well, I can answer. A gorilla, is in my case. literally true.
Diane Fossey of London, you are.
There are only 600 mountain gorillas in the world, as you know.
Of course.
And I was very lucky to be doing a film with Comic Relief. This isn't a plug, it's genuinely true. And about 2 weeks ago, I got back from the chemist this incredible set of these remarkable gorillas. There was one mother gorilla, and we were filming this little baby. They are the most beautiful things you've ever seen. I had to walk 3 hours up an equatorial forest thing, which I'm not moaning, it just, you know, when you're fat as I am. I know, no, but to see the real thing.
Abnormal pictures of you and your mates.
Oh, I'm sorry.
it was
just literally the answer. I was rather taken by surprise
it's
by
it. It's very good, that's
but
a very good answer.
Gorillas.
I normally get a gorilla to take mine.
Yeah, so I'm. Your last
mine
reel
were,
of
mine
films.
Were boring. Mine were just not boring. That's a terrible thing to say. Mine were my family.
Family stuff. That's nice. That's
tremendous. I mean, did I say boring? I meant tremendous.
My
children and my wonderful wife and things like that. That's what it was.
And Martine, how about you?
Mine was just normal. Just me and my friends hanging out, adult feathers in the air. Black and white disposable film. Really good.
Really?
Really, really good.
They come out really well. When they're developed.
That's right.
Always good to watch that. What was your last film, more importantly, Amber?
It was pictures of me and my mates at a fancy dress party.
And what did you go as?
The Pink Ladies.
A Pink Lady?
Yeah, we all went as Pink Ladies.
So it wasn't really fancy dress, it was a themed night?
Yeah, like Hollywood theme.
Oh, sounds brilliant. Right.
So yeah, there's no good. Monroe or not anything like that?
Say that again?
There was nobody came as Marilyn Monroe, it was just Pink Ladies.
We didn't have there was a few Pink Ladies. There was Robert De Niro, Julia Roberts.
Very strong.
Yes, James Bond, yes. Austin Powers.
That's an excellent thing.
Oh, like Martin's video.
Exactly, and that's what picked it. Right. OK, thanks very much for your question. Now, as a tribute to tomorrow night's Miss World, we have, as you know, been running our very own pageant of brains and beauty throughout the show. It's Miss Late Lunch 1998. Young Melanie.
Hello, Susan. Yes, the jury are out. They have their result, and it's in this gold envelope right here. I'm bringing it over to you now, Susan.
I'd love to talk, but obviously Stephen's received another message on his pager.
Who is that that you're phoning?
Can we have a drum roll, please, because I'm going to announce the results in reverse order. Third, Miss North End, Ali McCoist. Yay! Second, Miss West End, Stephen Fry. The winner of Miss Late Lunch 1998, it's Martine McCutcheon. Beautiful beauty,
thank you very much to all our guests this week. Sorry, join us next week when Graham Norton will be cooking for Joanna Lumley and
we're
going to
pass the volume now and join us Saturday, Channel 4, live from the Lighthouse.
Bye.
Good evening.